everyone. This is Coach Kat from Reef Beat Sports here in Des Moines. Today we're going to be talking about dynamic stretching. And you want to do dynamic stretching before you go out for a run. And the reason for dynamic stretching is that you're going to be moving your body. It's not just a pose and you hold it. We are going to be constantly moving. And it loosens up your joints. It loosens up your muscles. It gets the blood flowing to where we need it to be to have a good run. It also trains your brain to say, this is what I'm going to be doing. Okay, so first, I want to thank my runners, my 5K runners, who are going to help me demonstrate the exercises. So we're going to start from the top of the body and work our way down. First thing we're going to do is we're going to do shoulder rolls. Shoulders, helps warm up our neck. Let's get going the other way. Okay, here we go. The next thing we're going to do, hip circles. We're going to loosen the lower back. We're going to loosen our hip muscles. We're going to strengthen our core, and even better, we're going to help trim our waist. So stand, legs a little bit wider than hip length, and we're going to just rotate them around. Gonna get sexy with it.
Maybe you are.
Let's go the other way. So I don't know about you guys, but I'm also feeling this in my hamstrings. All right, that's done. Next thing we're gonna do is around the world lunges. Make sure everybody has enough room to not step on each other. We're going to do a forward lunge, a side lunge, a back lunge, and we're going to do that with a twist. And this is the one that's really going to get the blood moving. It's going to be total upper leg. It's going to get your butt and your hips. Everything's going to be going here. Okay, let's start with our right leg. We're going to lunge forward and up. We're going to lunge to the side. To the back, and we're going to twist towards the leg in front, back, and then up. Now let's do it again. The other thing to remember is when you're lunging, you do not want your knee to go over your toe. Let's go up, let's go to the side, and up, let's go to the back. We're going to twist, and up. Let's get that one more time. Side. Go back. Twist. Let's come up and let's do the other side. Let's go left leg forward. To the side. To the back. Twist now to the right side. And up. Forward. Side. This one, Okay, good. All right, we're going to do the ankle calf mobilization. And what this is going to do is take care of your foot, your ankles, and your lower leg, the whole shin and calf. So we want to touch our heel and touch our toe. It's really simple, but this is really great for preventing plantar fasciitis as well as shin splints. So this is a really important one. Let's get one more. Now let's go to the other side. And you probably want to do 7 or 8. I have no idea how many we did or how many we're doing. Oh, okay, thank you. Finally, the last one we're going to do are ankle moves. So let's go around. And I do like to kind of spread my toes in my shoe. Let's get about 4 or 5 going in one direction, 4 or 5 in the other. And ankle rolls. Why do we do ankle rolls? There we go.
Roll ankles.
We got it. Okay, let's get the other foot. So you should be feeling pretty loosened up at this point. We should be ready for our run. Get your sunglasses. Get your water. Get your phone. You guys ready for a run?
Rock it. Yeah.